How we doing, everybody? Scott Brown here, Construction Technology Partners. I'm going to do a video here today showing you how to convert your Trimble files over to Topcon TP3 or whatever Topcon files you're looking for. So a couple things before we get started. You're going to need Business Center that allows you to export. My version's 4.10, a little old. If you go down, load the newest version online, you're not going to have the ability to export. So if you don't have that, you can reach out to me. I can help you try to get that. And you need Office 3D as well, which is pretty easy to get a hold of. And then I'll also show you LSS Toolkit. Maybe make another video of that. We'll see how this goes. But so first off, I've got a couple files here. I've got SVL, SVD, so you can do it that way, or you can go DXF and TTM. I prefer to do this because when we bring it over and make it into a TP3, we'll maintain all the layers, and then on especially the machines, it's really nice because then we can you can edit layers on the machine as well as the data collector. So I'm gonna bring both of these in to the Business Center here. This is a pretty small project. That's why I picked this one. Just keep it simple. So you can see here, not a whole lot going on, but this is gonna be the same for regardless of the size of the project. So once we have our surface and our line work in here, I just go to export and we go to CAD, DFX exporter. Options, I just do select all, and then you can map where you want it to go. Let's call this scrap, whatever works for you. So I'm just gonna map that to there. I'm in survey feet, just hit export. Just gonna spit that out. So after that, I always go into Office 3D, and then I can do import line work from AutoCAD file. My bad. That was the original native file. We'll do this again here. Line work, import line work from AutoCAD file. So it's a scrap DXF file here. You could just bring in the original DXF. I usually just pull them in together. You can see it's the same thing. And then I can go into 10, import 10 from AutoCAD file, and use that same DXF. It'll generate a 10 surface, turn on triangles. So now we have our line work in our 10, we just need to get the calibration over. So we got that part done. At that point, sometimes I will go ahead and hit file, save, and you can name this. So that's gonna save it as a TP3 file. We'll just save it on desktop there. So now what we gotta do is we can come in here, we're gonna drop our calibration in here. This is the manual way of doing it. I typically just, as a habit, you don't really have to do this, but I always open a new project. I just think it makes it cleaner. I don't know. You do it however you want. You don't have to do that step. So I've got the .cal file here. You got to have the .cal file. You can, a couple other ways to get this data. And this is probably the easiest. So once we have our .cal in, we can go to field data, site calibration. We're going to have horizontal calibration. We're not going to set it to one. Vertical, shift, and incline plane. Hit compute. We'll say yes. So from here, it's going to give us our values from our calibration. So this is what I typically do here. Is now I've got my point. I've got my calculated point, my grid point. So now I can take, and I got to manually enter this information in to Office 3D. So I usually split these up side by side here, something like this. And then from here I can go project, control points, add, and then I'm just going to match this information over here. So these I can copy and paste. This information I have to enter it, so my latitude will be 39.0642457.92 tab, and then since I'm westerly, it needs to be a -94.29. If you're easterly, then it'd be a positive number. see it's a horizontal and a vertical point. So we're going to leave these two boxes checked. CP1. And you can see it's a tedious process, but not difficult to do. I'll show you the LSS Cal. It works good too, but has some problems that I ran into if you're using a newer TSC7 data collector. And if you've come across that and you got solutions, leave them in the comments. That'd be awesome. So as we get these entered here, we'll start getting residual values. Oh, so yeah, I messed up on that one already. So CP1, it's just a horizontal point. We don't have any vertical control on that. So we just need to make sure these match. CP2, like I said, you're just gonna do these. This isn't the world's best example because, yeah, they only used three vertical points in their setup, so it's not gonna compute a residual value. So
power off.
We're not gonna be able to confirm that number. But I'll show you how this comes out here. You'll start seeing the horizontal shit after I type this one in. 56.324. You can see where there's definitely some room for error in doing this. But it's pretty easy to check in yourself. So this point's using horizontal and vertical. You can see the residual values are starting to come in. They're not going to match until I get all four points in there. First time you do this, it takes a little bit, but after you've done it a few times, you can do it pretty quick. I gotta move my circle over here so I can see what I'm doing. 6, 4, 0, 534, 94.29, 30, 70, 821, 639, 058. So then we check our numbers, 14, 13, 23, and 24. Every once in a while I'll see one of these that will be a thousandth off. Every check I've ever done out in the field has never resulted in any issues. And you'll see we won't get any vertical because we don't have enough points. So not ideal to only do one, you know, where we don't have four vertical control. But you can see now that I hit this, we'll see we got 1, 2, 3, 4. We got our points in here. So now if I was to hit save, what I've done now is created a TP3 file that could go right into a Topcon data collector or machine. And assuming, you know, the base position same as when it's calibrated, should fire right up and work off that. There's also a program called LSS Toolkit. I'll put the link in the description, but if we were to click on this, I've had it installed on my computer already, but that's the CAL file. So this is gonna give us a vertical error because it doesn't have, yeah, so we'd have to look and see which point was turned off. So you're gonna have to double check that. So if I look back at my file that I moved here, I don't remember which one was turned off. Oops, I've already got it open down here. Project control points. So CP1, the vertical was turned off for whatever reason. So you can come in here, edit station. Yeah, but those numbers, we're not getting the same there. So I've had issues in the past with this working. But then right here, if everything agreed, then you can save it as a Topcon GC3 file. So what's nice about that, in Topcon, instead of a .cal, you have what they call a GC3 file. So you can actually just import, if you had a calibration, you can import your GC3 file right here. So from there, file management's real nice. They create your TP3. You have the ability from there, if they just needed the line work, you can export line work to LM3 files or the 10 surface. If it was just an updated surface, you can do that as well. But that's how you go from, and you can do the same thing with SVL, SVD, but like what I said, what it'll do is if we do it with those, when we go into our project and we look at our layer selection, there would be just layer zero. Everything would be on layer zero. By using the DXF and the TTM, it allows us to have these different layers, which is really nice because in the data collector and the machine, you can toggle those on and off and change colors and give the, you know, the operator those things a little bit more control. So I'll get all those links posted. If you guys got questions or run into stuff with converting these files, reach out, let us know. We'd be glad to help. Yeah, thanks again.